Have you noticed these weird spots or floaters in your vision? Well, multiple times a day, every eye doctor gets asked that question. What are these weird spots floating around in my vision? So in this video, we're gonna go over everything you need to know about visual floaters. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. EyeGuy, with the show that keeps your eyes healthy and your vision clear, and I do videos all about the eyes, including educational videos like this one, so make sure you're subscribed for my future videos. Now let's talk about these strange spots in your vision. The first thing I want to talk about are the actual symptoms or what people actually notice when they see these floaters. Usually people describe their floaters in a few different ways. Sometimes they can be dark black or gray specks. Sometimes they look like little bubbles or clusters of bubbles, or they can look like hairs or strands or strings in their vision, or maybe they're looking through cobwebs, lots of strands and strings, cobwebs in their vision. And the floaters will drift around your vision up and down, left and right, and they'll move with eye movement as well. So if you try and look at a floater, it will dart off when you move your eye. Now, most of the time when people have noticed their floaters, they notice them when they've been driving, maybe looking at the bright blue sky, or, and this might be TMI, I don't get this one as much, but they would say that they noticed the floaters when they were sitting on the toilet, going to the bathroom, and they were staring at their bright white wall and noticed their floaters. But nowadays, I don't get that one as much because people are looking at their phones and not their wall. With that being said, people also have told me they notice the floaters when they're looking at their computer screen and sometimes their phone if they are looking at a bright background. Now the next big question is, what are floaters or what causes floaters? The eyeball is filled with a clear gel-like substance called vitreous humor. And this helps give the eyeball its shape. It also acts like a cushion to the eyeball. And it also helps light get focused to the back of the eye. Now this vitreous gel is made up of about 98%, 99% water, and about 2% type 2 collagen. And that's what makes it this jelly structure, this jelly or jello. Now naturally over time, this vitreous gel will start to degrade or liquefy. This is called cinereses. And it'll leave behind these little fluid-filled pockets in there. And sometimes you actually see those as the floaters, these little spots in your vision. But it'll also leave behind these little lines, lines separating from the liquid and the collagen that gets left behind. And these hard edges are what you see as little hairs or strings or cobwebs in your vision. Now, usually when you can see these floaters, either the pockets of fluid or the strands of collagen, is usually when you're looking at a bright background, bright white wall, bright blue sky, and it casts a shadow to the back of your retina. And that's what you're actually seeing. You're seeing the shadow of these little bits inside the gel of your eye. Now, who usually gets floaters? This degradation of the vitreous or the gel of the eye is age-related and completely normal. The older you get, the more the vitreous will liquefy and cause floaters. In fact, by the time you reach 80 years old or older, you have a 66% chance of having floaters in your vision. Now that being said, younger people can also get floaters as well, especially if you're nearsighted or myopic, meaning distance vision is blurry, close up is clear. When you're nearsighted, typically your eyeball is longer than it should be. The axial length of the eye is longer. And so that leaves more space for that vitreous or that gel to cover, and that makes it more prone to degradation. And this can cause you to have floaters when you're younger. I noticed floaters when I was in my 20s. My floaters really haven't gotten any worse, but you can be young, nearsighted, and also see floaters. A few more things that can cause floaters, obviously trauma to the eye or the head, that jostling of the eye can cause floaters, as well as surgery to the eyeball can also cause floaters. Now, like I said before, these types of floaters can be annoying, but normal and harmless. But, floaters can sometimes be a sign of something more serious going on in the eyes. So let's talk about that. When are floaters dangerous? When should you be concerned about seeing floaters? The most common thing that you'll hear is if you see floaters with flashes of light in your vision, pretty much like lightning streaks or flashes off to the side of your eyes, that could be a sign of something bad happening in your eye. Now, one thing to understand about the vitreous gel is that it's actually attached to the retina of the inside of the eye, almost attached kind of like Velcro. And as that gel shrinks or degrades, it will pull on the retina, kind of like this glue is pulling on my hand as I separate it. and that pulling motion will excite the cells of the retina. The cells will send a signal back to the brain. The brain will register it as light and make it think that it's seeing light. Now, if that vitreous gel is really attached to the retina, sometimes it can actually rip or tear the retina. It'd be kind of like this glue ripping my hand open. And that's what we call a retinal detachment. And that's why it's so important. If you see new floaters and flashes of light, that could be a sign that the gel, the vitreous gel, actually ripped the retina. Now, if you have a retinal detachment, it is very important that you catch that early on. If that retina continues to rip, kind of like pulling the glue off the hand, it can potentially rip all the way down the entire retina and also rip off the important part of your vision, the macula, the center of your vision. If this happens, then your vision will be significantly decreased. In fact, you may go blind. And this is where I want you to pay attention very closely. If you're experiencing any of these situations or scenarios, or you're worried about your floaters, then you want to go in and see your eye doctor right now. This is an actual eye emergency. You can get in today. If it's the weekend, Saturday, Sunday, Monday night at midnight, you can get in right now. They will see you. It's that important because you want to keep your eyes alive. Now, if you're just experiencing new floaters, maybe you're not experiencing flashes of light, but you feel like you have new floaters that you haven't had before, that's also an emergency. You want to go in there and get them checked out by your eye doctor. There are some people that will have new floaters, but maybe not notice flashes of light in their vision. And it could still be a sign of a retinal detachment, sometimes a retinal hole where just a small piece of the retina gets plucked off. Also important to get it checked out. Also, if you notice a curtain or a darkening coming from the side of your vision, that's also a dead giveaway of a retinal detachment and you need to get it checked out right now. Now, the first common question we get is, what are these floaters? The second common question is, what can be done about the floaters? Now I'll talk about what can be done about the typical normal floaters, and bear with me, not a lot of people like the answer to this question. The most common answer, and probably the one you're not going to like, is that we'll monitor or observe the floaters. A lot of times the floaters will settle down lower in the eye, outside of the vision, or the brain will learn how to filter the floaters out so you won't notice them as much as time goes on. And I see that a lot with patients. I'll see patients that notice their floaters and then maybe I'll see them a year later, ask them about their floaters, and they'll say, oh, I totally forgot that I had floaters. I don't really notice them as much. And we'll compare pictures of their eyes side by side where we could see the floaters and they'll be almost exactly the same. So in those cases, a lot of times the brain learns how to filter the floaters out, or they just stopped paying attention to those floaters. The next possible treatment for your vitreous floaters can be pretty invasive and risky, and it's something called a vitrectomy. Pretty much you'll have a surgeon go into your eye and suck the gel, the vitreous, out of your eye, bringing the floaters with it and replace it with a new fluid. And as you can imagine, this procedure can be pretty risky, can have a lot of complications with the surgery. And so most surgeons are hesitant to do this type of procedure. The floaters would have to be significant, would have to be decreasing your vision or decreasing your quality of life to warrant the risk or warrant the complications, the possible complications of a vitrectomy. The next possible treatment is the use of a YAG laser. You can have a surgeon laser your larger floaters into smaller, not as noticeable pieces, which can help your symptoms of seeing these visual floaters. Now, a lot of people ask me about natural remedies of floaters, or maybe eye drops, medications, or diets that can help get rid of your floaters. And I plan on making a full video specifically on that topic because I get that question all the time. But bottom line is, there's nothing really concrete or proven to get rid of floaters, but make sure that you keep an eye out for one of my future videos coming out. If you have any questions at all, make sure that you comment them below. I am there to answer any questions that I can. Hey, thanks for watching the video. Make sure you hit that like button if you found value from this video. I'm Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Stay focused. Make sure you check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video. Oh, yeah, I see my floaters looking at this bright white light shining on me. I have a few hair strands, a couple of them look like little grape clusters, little specks. Yeah. Pretty much the same ones I've always had.